wasn't much holding this all together except the skin. See that? That was falling apart, boy. Wasn't a lot holding it together. Oh well. It's all getting new. This is the key sheet, what I call the key sheet of the ceiling of the 54 Aljoa. Now when I say key sheet, I mean it's somewhat in the center and it's the first sheet you replace, and it usually has the top vent in it. I call that the key sheet. The reason you don't want to just rip all the top and all the front and rear out first and start from there is because the walls will fall over. I replace one sheet at a time. That way I maintain the proper width of the trailer. You don't want to end up with an eighth or a quarter of an inch too wide, because then your roof won't fit back on. And even if you're replacing the roof, you still don't want that to happen. Now, one thing I want you to notice about this is these lines here. You see, most trailers, the cabinets, the top sheet that goes over the cabinets are nailed down through into the cabinets from the top. It's one of the reasons it's very hard to remove the cabinets from underneath. There's no screws or nails or anything under there. They're fastened from the top down. The cabinets are brought into the trailer when there are no walls, and placed and secured to the floor, and then the walls are put up. They're tilted up and held in place temporarily while they're fastened to the walls. The wall is fastened at the bottom to the trailer, to the bed frame, and then, not the bed itself, but to the main frame of the trailer all along the bottom. And then they fastened to the cabinets. They're all held in the right place. Of course, the trailer has to be square for this. And then once the walls are tilted up and in place, they're held in place temporarily while the ceiling is put in. And they start with this sheet here. You put this sheet in, the cabinets are nailed into place. I don't know what sheet they start with, but this is the one I like to start with. I remove it, and then I put the new one in. Now usually, the framing along the top here is not glued to the paneling, but in this case, it is. You can see the glue they did here. You can see that this happened at the factory, being that this is the back side and yet the glue was running this way is normally facing up, that means that this was done on the floor or on a bench somewhere and then placed on in the trailer across the span of the trailer while it was all put together like this. Now I did notice that they did not glue the edges, which is good. That makes it easier to get out, but these three pieces are glued to the paneling along with the framing for the hole, and you can see here's their what's left of their crown for the top of the vent. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to build the same thing and then put it back in. So we're going to start by taking measurements and transposing them to the new piece of birch. Before we do that, however, I'm going to go ahead and cut some framing with my new table saw. These pieces here, this dimension is an inch and a quarter. Now that means that all the curving has to be a total of an inch and a quarter, which means two pieces of 3/8 and two pieces of 1/4 inch all laminated on top of each other for the curving. So that's going to be a lot of curving to cut and place, but that's the way they did it. So maybe we'll use a table saw for some of that too. We want to transfer these dimensions over so that we can nail the cabinet, nail this piece down to the cabinet so it's nice and tight against the gimp, the welting that's all along the cabinets. And then of course we also want to frame in for our vent hole. And we'll usually I put the curbing on afterwards. I don't want to have any more weight on this thing than need be to begin with to get it up there. I'll put it on later. We also have a couple of holes for electrical that we'll put in. This one, this hole, and another one on the other end, the same place. I'll get these nails out of here so I don't hurt myself. scratchy little rusty nails. And now I'm going to go ahead and play with my new skill set, my new table saw. Now, just another little note. In order to remove this piece, I took my cat's paw. I've got one called a digger, and it really digs in. It's not your normal cat's paw. But I removed all the nails on the framing that go through, and I removed all the nails in the top of the paneling that go through, and all the nails that go through to the cabinets. You have to remove all those nails, and of course you have to remove the curbing too first. So you remove all the curbing, the nails that hold the curbing in, remove all the nails that hold the framing into the curbing, or into the framing that's under the curbing, in other words the wall framing, and then you remove all the nails that are holding the paneling itself to the top of the walls. Then you can just lift it up, hook it over the side, bring it back here, and make a copy of it. Nothing to it. You're right. Okay, another thing we want to make note of is that our framing, our rafters, are 82 1/4 inches long, besides being 1 1/4 inches tall. It doesn't matter how wide they are. I'm using 2x4s to cut up. So the distance, of course, in our hole here is 14, should be 14x14, and it is. You can make it just a hair bigger, maybe 14 1/8, just so for easy fits. But the full width of this piece of paneling is a full 48. Yep, full 48. And the length of this paneling, which is actually the width of the trailer, is going to be 84 inches. So you make notes in your little notebook on these measurements. You'll always want to cut all of your rafters and framing pieces that go the width of the trailer to 82 1/4 for this trailer. You're always going to want to cut the width of the paneling to 84 inches. And then when you install the paneling, you make sure that it's flush with the sides of the walls, the wood in the walls, not the metal, the sides of the walls, the wood wall framing. So you attach one side, then come to the other side, pull the wall in, pull the paneling in until it's flush, and then you go ahead and staple it. That will maintain the proper width of the trailer, the top, so that if you're saving your roof, then it'll fit again. Remember, always use proper safety glasses. Okay, what I've done is transposed the measurements from this piece over to this piece. I have not put the two small pieces in, 14 inch pieces for the vent yet, top vent. And I'm using this Power Grab Loctite paneling adhesive. And just because the wood is bowed a little tiny bit, usually bows in the direction of the cut, I've put this big old 5-gallon propane tank across the middle to suck it all down. Okay, this is the back piece of a brand new piece of birch. And then of course when I put it up there, then the framing, the new framing will fit over the seams when I get the next piece up, and that will be nailed from the other side with brads because it gets covered with screen molding. Screen molding is, if you don't know what screen molding is, you can look it up on the website, probably the Home Depot website. It's the same stuff that we used to hold the screen on our wooden doors with, our wooden screen doors. That's why it's called screen molding. It's really nice stuff, stains up really well, goes along great with the birch, and it's what was in the Aljoa to begin with. So it only gets out along the seams, nowhere else. And because we're gluing it, there won't be any twisty nails. So from the other side, so that should be really nice looking, no twisty nails. I like it. All right, I've got weight in the middle, and it's not so much that the framing is bowed. My table is a little bit bowed in the middle, a little bit concave, just a tad. So anyway, I've got weight in the middle holding all this down so that the glue will be making contact with the paneling nice and tight. So it's a good idea to do that anyway, whether you have a bowed table or not. My table isn't that bowed, but it's bowed enough, about an eighth of an inch lower in the middle. So, and I've got the framing in for the hole for the vent, as you can see there. I'm just letting this dry now, and I'm going to flip it over, and then I think I'm going to apply the shellac, two or three coats of shellac, so that I don't have so much of that stuff running down my arm. And actually, I think the owner is probably going to do the rest of the shellac, but this will help him too. He won't have it running down his arm. I'm using, it's morning, and it's about 55, 58 degrees. And I'm using about a 15% mixture of denatured alcohol with my amber shellac. And I'm using a brush to apply it. It's a good brush. It's not the best brush, but it's a good one. And like I've said in previous videos, the whole idea is keeping it wet. Well, in the morning when it's cool, it's much easier to keep it wet. And you don't want to see brush strokes where you start and stop, so you always make your last sweep into the stuff that's already there, see? That way, when you do this, there's no brush mark where it starts or stops. Now John Palmer uses the French polish method, which basically just means you use a rag like a t-shirt, something soft, and you rub it on. I want to try that method, but not on this job, because I don't want to try anything new right now. I don't know that I may have to get used to. I don't have time for experiments. My brushing is tried and true. Now this is the ceiling. The only thing I am doing new here is as I've shown, I pre-built this ceiling panel. The framing is already attached on the wrap on the back. So I'm shellacking it first before I place it, and that way I don't have shellac running down my arm when I'm trying to do the ceiling. Every once in a while you lose a hair out of the brush. You need to get that. I'll tell you, when you pay this kind of money, I paid $8 for this brush, when you pay that kind of money, you shouldn't be losing hairs. But that's the way things are today. So this is the first coat. And we'll get one more coat of amber. Let's see if I do that.
stroke him to the previous run. If any holidays. When you get to the end like this, just go to the edge. Go into your last strokes. Another hair. Let that dry. Shouldn't take very long to dry before you put the next coat on. Okay, it's only been sitting about 20 minutes and it's already dry, dry to the touch. So let's do it again. A little tight on room here. Now I'm really good, because I've done so much of this, I'm really good at matching the color as far as the depth, how dark it gets. You want to keep in mind a few things, and that is, with an old trailer that's been used a lot, there's going to be cigarette smoke on the walls and the ceiling. There's going to be just dirt that's collected. Sunlight has got in there, heat has been in there, and over time the color has probably darkened a bit. That's not really what you want to match. You don't want to match what's there. You want to match what can be there. By that I mean, what you want to do is take some denatured alcohol and clean up the old paneling that's staying in the trailer that you're not going to replace. Clean up an area there. Might want to just go ahead and clean up the whole trailer first. It's a good idea. And then match what you're left with. The nice thing about shellac is that when you add more shellac on it, or if you use a rag with denatured alcohol, it reliquefies the old shellac. Brings it back to sort of a liquid. So, and you're not gonna, I don't mean that it brings it totally back to a liquid, but it does break the surface and reliquefy that. So when you rub a, clean up an area in the trailer on the birch that you're going to match, then you know what you're matching to, because that's what you want to do to the whole trailer. You want to clean it up anyway to get rid of cigarette smoke stains and cooking oil stains and stuff like that that's built up over the years. And then you'll end up with a nice match between the two. Now when I get done with this second coat, I'm going to do exactly that. I'm going to grab the other ceiling, which is behind me on the other side of the screen. I'm going to clean it up. And then I'm going to do a match, see where I'm at. this is much easier when it's cool than it is when it's warm, because when it's warm, this stuff tends to dry out pretty quickly. And it's hard to keep the brush strokes out when it does that. Because you gotta keep it wet. Okay, I'm gonna shut the camera down and continue on.
Okay, now from what I can see, I'm really close. I don't know if you can see this. I'm gonna get out of the sun. Get out of the, move the shadow. Right there is where I cleaned it all up. That whole area there. Too bad it's, this is hard to judge on camera. But anyway, right there in the sunlit area, and right here in the sunlit area, is with two coats and a bug. Watch out for the bugs. What I'm gonna do now, I think a third coat is in order of amber. Third coat of amber is in order, but I'm gonna mix it with 50% denatured alcohol. Send it down a whole lot, because I don't need, otherwise I think it'll end up a little too dark. And I also want it all to blend in better now, because you can actually see some of the areas where the brush has laid it in a little bit thicker along the seams of this paneling than anywhere else. So like right here, you see that? I don't like that. So I'm going to use a lot of alcohol on this next coat, try and blend it all in. All right, I'm hoping that you can see the match in this light. I'm gonna put another tarp up over here to keep the sun out from that direction. It's winter, so the sun's low. It's not really affecting the finish any or the drying time, but it's hard to get a good photograph of the match, and it's a really good, I'm really happy with it. So unfortunately it doesn't look the same on camera as it does to the human eyeball, which I only have one good one now. But yeah, I do like the match. It's very good. I think right there you can see it. So that's what we're gonna go with. It's two coats of 15% alcohol, and then finish it off with a third coat of 50% alcohol is what I'm doing. This changes with your conditions. Temperature, humidity, all that. So you have to do your own experiments to figure it all out. But I like this, so I'm going with it. Okay, now it looks a little darker at the end of this sheet, but that's only because it's being shaded by this sheet, which I have up there. Not only for comparison, but to block the sun. So, I'm very happy. There's the good, here's a good place to look at it. You got a little bit of shine over here on the left side coming in. So look at this area right here, and then look at that area over there. I think it matches pretty good. Especially when you think about the fact that inside on the walls, that this is gonna get, not only rubbed down with denatured alcohol, it will get at least one, if not two coats of clear, just as this will. This will get two coats of clear after it's installed. Just because I can't really afford the time. Maybe I'll put one coat of clear on it before I install it. I might do that. Actually, I could put two coats of clear on it, then it'd be done, and it wouldn't run down the owner's arm. So I might do that. I'm making up my mind as I go here. As you move around, it changes. As you move around and look at it in different parts of light. So I'm real happy with it. All right, very happy with it. It's the right color. So you can see there. Just needs the other stuff, and the trailer will have to be shined up a little bit. cleaned up in a coat of clear. So when this is dry, which probably won't be till for a few hours, I'm probably not going to install this until tomorrow morning. So this will sit here overnight. Makes the going kind of slow, but that's okay. I want quality here. This is a really nice trailer. 54 Aljoa, boy, that's a really nice trailer, and I want it to be good. I want it to be nice. So this is going to sit here, and I will go out and do some other things to the trailer, like getting the next sheet ready to remove. The sheet that we'll be replacing it with is already under here, face down, ready to go. Alrighty, so there we go. Having this framing glued on here already makes it very easy to install this paneling, because normally without it, it tends to dip in the middle from gravity, and it makes it very hard to get it pulled all the way out to the edges to staple. With the framing on here, it doesn't add that much extra weight. It makes the sheet very sturdy, very easy to lay up here, either with two people or even one. I just take a blanket and lay it over the edge here, stand it up from the bottom, from down there, and flop it over so it's hanging over a little more than halfway. Gravity holds it there while I go inside, lift the sheet up, and place it where I need it. Very simple to do. I love this idea. From now on, all my trailers are going to get built like this. So I'm going to glue the framing on to the back first. At least two pieces like this, 15 inches apart or 16 inches on center. And then you just nail the seam rafters in. Okay, just nail them in on each end, or screw them in on each end. And then you go ahead and nail up from the bottom for the seams. So that works very well. I'm getting ready to do this end sheet here on the radius. That one is being shellacked right now, so I'm preparing to take this sheet off so that I can install this one. And maybe I'll video that so you can see me doing that one. But yeah, very happy with this process. Thank you, Aljoa. Good idea. All right, I've got the new key sheet in, and looks great. There's where it meets up with the old panel. This is the only panel that's staying in here. We'll clean this up. I'm pretty sure it's staying in. It could get changed. I don't know yet, but I think it depends on how it cleans up. I'm gonna try cleaning it up first. If I don't like it, then I'll change it. But so far, it looks like a great match. Just needs to be cleaned up, shine, and get a clear coat on it. And like I said, I could change it. There's the key sheet. I don't have the hole routed out yet. I'll do that in a little while. Getting other things done right now. Got the next sheet off. This sheet is fairly busy because it attaches to this cabinet and to this cabinet. And then plus it's got a vent pipe coming up through. Good timing on the compressor as usual.